Notes can do more than you think. You probably don't know that most likely the best notes-taking app is the one that you have already built on your phone. So everyone just needs to stop. We all need to stop looking for the best notes app or the best productivity app. I was one of those people where I started with notes, and I thought, oh, you know, notes is quite basic. In a world where productivity is vital, one app stands above the rest. Apple Notes is the ideal tool for organizing your thoughts, capturing ideas, and boosting productivity. So in this video, I will share some cool, interesting tips and tricks with it so that you can use it with its full ability. Starting with handy gestures. I was amazed by those gestures features. While it may not appear very practical at first, I can guarantee that it is quite the opposite. First gesture, speed access the Notes app. You know, it's not the quick note you've heard about or used, certainly. Just long press the Notes app on the home screen. You can quickly create a new note and start directly to document your thoughts. Also, from the same list, you can quickly scan documents. Beside, you can quickly create new checklists like this. Or this. Second and third gesture. Swipe right on a note in the outline. You can reveal the pin note button. This will pin your important or love note on the top of the list for speed access. But if you swipe left on a note in the outline, you can share, move, or delete the note. Fourth gesture. In a folder has numbers of notes, swipe up or down. With two fingers across notes to select multiple notes at once, for the purpose of organization, delete or move. Fifth gesture. In a note, select text, then scrunch in with three fingers. You will copy what you have selected. You can see the copy word above, so how you can paste it. Scrunch out with three fingers, it will paste the copied text. It might be difficult from the first sight, but it's worthy to try. Last one and the most I use and love. Rearrange lines and undo and redo. Swipe at lines. Swipe it left or right and leave wherever you want for more organization. Beside to undo and redo recently inputs to the note. Swipe left or right with three fingers. Look at the top menu, you can see the arrows of it. You can use it instead of swipe if you need any time. Let's jump to integrating notes with reminder. All of us have some important notes that we need to be notified with. It's valuable content at specific times, the things you're going to cross off like a to-do list or a grocery list, something you want to keep track. Notes app will not do this. So, access the note you want to be reminded about. Click the share button on the top right corner like that. Ensure that collaborate is turned off. Change it to send a copy. Then click the reminder app at the bottom as you see. This will add your note to Reminder app. A new window will open where you can include any necessary information. You can fill all the info manually as you want, or use another easy method. By using Siri to send the note to Reminder app, just be on the note itself and say, "Hi Siri," or use the side button, and start to say, "Reminder me about this tomorrow at 8 p.m. So as you see, you will get a reminder for that. Hope it's useful for you. Another amazing feature, book highlights. This is something I never thought notes could do, but it does. Apps like Readwise help you sync all the highlights from your ebooks from Kindle and other services like Apple Books, Kobo, etc. But these are subscription-based services. However, I found a workaround for those who want a free alternative to keeping a record of all their book highlights. Here's what you do. Open a note, tap on the camera icon, and choose Scan Text. This opens the camera's viewfinder, which is visible on the bottom half of the screen. Simply point this at the book you are reading, whether it's a paperback or a Kindle ebook, and then tap the live text icon on the bottom right corner of the viewfinder. You can then selectively choose the text you want to highlight and voila. Or you can use it the standard use. You can scan printed or handwritten text directly into the Notes app and edit it later. Podcast journal. Podcasts are great to listen to when you are occupied with something else and just need white noise in the background. But sometimes you come across an interesting piece of information in the podcast that you instantly want to save. Well, Notes is once again here to save your day. Apple Podcasts now comes with a live transcript, which you can select, copy, and add to an existing note. The way I do this is by first selecting the text from the transcript of the podcast and copying it. Then I go back to the podcast player, tap on the three dots, and select Share Episode. From the Share menu that pops up, I choose Notes app and choose my podcast folder that I created for all my podcast highlights, and then simply paste the selection to a new or existing note of that podcast channel. Use dictation in Notes. Get your thoughts down, no typing required. Here's how to dictate into the Notes app. First, open a note and tap it to bring up the keyboard. The text will appear on the screen as you speak, and you can add line breaks and punctuation with your voice too. Just tap to microphone to get started. New line, a likable robot loses its way, smiley. Now let's dive into the interesting part of the video, note flow. Step-by-step guide. From starting blank note like this to creating note like this. Let's make it the guru's way. Open new note from the home screen after long press, the note app, and then choose new note. By the way, you can open new note by using Siri. Just say, hey Siri, open new note, or use the control center. Follow the steps to add the note shortcut to the control center. The first line of the note becomes its title. You can change this from settings anytime. Tap the table button or the formatting button to add a table, title, heading, or bulleted list. You can also touch and hold to quickly open a list of formatting options. So they're a brief for how you can make the perfect note. Start with title. Insert bulleted list line. Another line, then the third line, I need to be sub-bulleted list. We can use the gesture if you remember. Swipe left or swipe right wherever you want and leave to arrange the lines. Back to the new bulleted list line. Swipe left as you can see. Continue the process as it's needed for your note. Jump to adding checklists from the toolbar on the keyboard. You can choose numbers or whatever you need from the formatting. To add something from another app, like a location or website, tap the Share button in the app that you want to share from. Tap the Notes app, then select the note that you want to add an attachment to, then tap Save. So far in this note flow, we have discussed how to create a new note instantly, format a note, add a photo or video, add an attachment, organize the note, and give it the best professional look as possible as we can. Besides the amazing features I have shared at the beginning of the video, let me know which feature you love and use, which part you think we could cover later in details. I recommend to check this iCloud guide to know everything you need to know about the iPhone backup and data sync, and most important thing, not loss your data.